Let's model an electrical panel from Fortnite. Here I am in Blender with nothing in my scene, and I've got a couple of reference images that I found. And this is what we're going to do. It's relatively simple, but we're going to have to do some thinking ahead of time to get these parts in here. If we have a look at this side view right here, we can see there's a sort of a front panel here, and then there's a little division line here, and then there's the back panel with an indent here. This front panel has these grooves in it. And we're going to do all this in geometry. This could very, very well be done in the texture. We also have this main cutaway, and those are the main parts. Underneath, we have some tubes or whatever, and that's all the detail that I can see on this. Even these dials look like they're probably part of the texture, but we're going to do it all in modeling. So we're going to have to put some thought into that. So let's press 1 and look from the front orthographic view. Press Shift A, Mesh, Plane. To bring in a plane, go into Edit Mode by pressing Tab RX90. And let's bring this up. I'm holding down Control and it's snapping. I'm going to box select these top vertices and I'm going to bring them up to maybe there. Okay, I'm going to select it all and press SX. Just widen it a little bit. And I think I may come up just a little bit more. So just rough out the shape that you think you're going to want. So now this is going to create that front panel, but I'm going to select it. And thinking ahead a little bit, I'm going to Shift D to duplicate it. And I'm just going to pull it back out of the way, P, and break it out. So I have that. I'm going to create the back out of this and the front out of this. So I'm going to come back into the front, and I'm going to give it a little bit of thickness. I'm going to press E, and I'm going to pull back in the Y direction. And I want it maybe just like that. All right, I'm going to come into the back section here, go into Edit Mode, A to select it all, E, and I'm going to pull back further. Something like that. I'm going to keep them a little bit far apart. All right, so now we're going to come into the front. I'm going to press 3 for face selection, select this front face. And what I want to create is this region here. It slopes in, and that's what we're going to do right there. So I'm going to I think I want a bit of a flat section and then to come out. So I'm going to do is I'm going to press I to inset. I'm going to come in, hold Shift, and come like that. And then I'm going to press E to extrude and sort of gesture outwards a little ways like that. And then I'm going to press S to scale and angle it down like that. Now we're going to be rounding these corners in a moment on the front and on this piece. But first we need to do that thinking about what we need. So I'm going to need some indents here. So we're going to put in some edge loops. And I'm going to need this section. So we're going to put in edge loops for this. So let's do these parts here first. Okay, so let's come into the front piece. Go into Edit Mode, look from the very front. I'll deselect. I'm going to press Control R right there. Click. And I'm going to drag. And you're going to notice that this edge is angled, and I want it straight. So I'm going to straighten it in the x-axis, so I'm going to press SX0. And let's see if that's at a reasonable position. All right, I'm looking at this distance. So I think I'll pull it out a little bit more. And I'm going to do another one, Control-R, bring it, slide it in. Let's try there. Let's go SX0 to straighten that one. And see if I've left myself enough room on this side. So this one is pretty much in the middle, it looks like. I could go for that. I think that's probably all right. So I've got those in position. I'm not going to do anything else with them yet. I'm now going to lay out what I need to create this indent here, right in the middle. So I'm going to press Control R. And then I'm going to press Control B and pull. Make sure my mouse is rolled back to 0. I don't want any edges in there. And now I'm going to pull it out. And I'm going to click. And then I'll come back to the diagram. This top part, we've got almost an equal distance on the sides and on the top. Not quite, maybe. So let's put an edge somewhere around there. And let's make this straight in the z-axis, SZ0. And I'm going to pull it down a little bit more. And let's bring in another one. Let's make it SZ0. And then we can always reposition that. How far down does this one come? Now I'm looking at the bottom. It's more than halfway. It's about 2/3. So let's come down like this. And then I can relook at these and decide. Maybe if I shift alt and click that edge and this edge, maybe I do want to SX, scale them in the X a little bit and do that. So it's very long and rectangular. Is that what I want here? Yeah, it is long and rectangular. All right, I pretty much have what I need there. And so I think it's now time to round out the corners on all of this. All right, so I'm going to take this piece and pull it a little closer, like that. With that one selected, I'm going to shift and select this one and go into edit mode. I'm now in edit mode for all of this. So now I'm going to shift alt and click that edge, and this edge, and just go around the four corners. This edge and this edge, this edge and this edge. And this way I'll get the same curve on the front panel and on the back panel. So let's have a look at this. It's nicely rounded here. Okay, on all of that. And then we'll do this split in a bit. All right, so let's go Control B, hold down Shift and pull. That'll split them like that. Get a nice split. Then roll your mouse up 1, 2, 3 for a total of 5 edges in there, 5 lines. And release. Okay, so far so good. Now we'll come back into edit mode, shift and alt and click all the way around here. So I'm going to have to select all of this stuff. So I'm holding down shift and alt and I'm going around and I'm trying to make sure I get the entire edge. I'm going to do the same thing on this one. That should get the whole thing. I'm going to bevel this, and I'm not going to worry about this piece right now. Let's just do these ones. Control B and pull. I don't have to have 5 edges, but I think I will leave it like that. It'll be nice and smooth. On the other hand, I can roll back to 0, so there's just the 2. Let's try 1. So we get a little bit of an edge. We'll worry about smoothing later. Let's come into this one. Shift alt and click there. We'll shift alt and click there. We'll do the same thing, control B. All right, so this piece here, I'm just gonna move a little closer to there. I can bring that even closer when I want to. And now we'll do the dividing line on this piece. So let's go into edit mode. Control R to add an edge loop. Slide it back a little bit, and then let's have a look at the reference. How far it is back. Okay, so it's about 2/3 and 1/3, something like that. I think that's probably okay. Or maybe a little bit back. All right, the way we're going to do this is Control B, hold down Shift and pull, roll my mouse back to 0, and just get a split, an area in there that I think is wide enough for my cut. I click there. So that's going to be what I'm going to use. E, click, Alt, S. There we go. I think that's better. All right, that's quite far in there, but I'm going to select, hold Shift and Alt to click both of those edges. Zoom in a little ways so I can see inside there. And Control B again to bevel. Pull it like this. And 1, 2, do something like that. You can even do 3 if you want. So I now have that cutaway in there. Alright, so that's fine. I can take this and I can move it a little bit closer like that. Let's focus just on that. Let's come in. I haven't beveled this. And I think what I'm going to do is press 3 for face selection and C for paint select. And just drag my mouse over all of this, making sure I don't select anything else. Let's X faces. Let's delete those faces. And then let's press number 2 for edge selection and Shift-Alt and click there and get that edge. Let's just go E and S and pull it in and just don't worry about that anymore. It's going to be covered. But let's shift and alt and click that edge now, and Control B to bevel it and just pull. So I've got like five edges in there. That's all right. Slash key to reveal the other part, and now I have a bit of an edge, a bevel on there, and you don't see the inside. Okay. All right, now before I get into smoothing this, let's go into this and let's grab these two edges, the outside ones. These are the ones that are going to make the cut that goes down here. So let's do that. I'm going to do it by beveling. So come over here on an angle, Control B and pull, roll my mouse back to zero. Give yourself a space that's not too big, not too small, something like that. Let's press E and Alt S and push this time. And then look at this and make sure it looks okay. I think it looks okay. Shift and Alt and click the edge. Okay, so that should go all the way through, only on the front panel. Zoom in nice and close. And let's Control B, pull like this, 1, 2, 3. Now that will catch light. All right, so we have that piece. Now before we go any further, I'm gonna switch to the cavity shader and that'll help me see the edges and it'll look nice. We'll deal with shading very, very soon. All right, so we have that. Let's look from the front and go into edit mode and deselect everything. 3 for face selection and select that face that we want to push in. Okay, so here we go. We're going to do that now. Press E and gesture in on the Y. Pull it in and let's have a look at how far it goes in. It's a little bit hard to tell. Let's try about there. All right. Then before we lose that selection, let's press SX and pull in just a little bit. We're just pulling these sides inwards a little. SZ, pull down just a little bit so we have a bit of an angle here. Then while we're in edge selection number 2, select that edge. We're going to pull it up a little ways. Okay, because it comes up like that. Pull it up even more. Now, make sure we're in edge selection, shift and alt and click these somewhat vertical edges here. I'm going to round this out a little bit anyhow, so these aren't sharp. You see this is kind of rounded there, so we're going to try that. So let's look at an edge here, it doesn't matter which one. Control B, pull. You can roll back to zero if you want, give a little bit of that kind of separation, and 1, 2, 3. And let's have a look. Sometimes we'll have some problems down on this one, but it looks okay to me. All right, we'll do that. Let's go back in, deselect, shift and alt and click this edge. And then just hold shift and alt and go around. Make sure you get these corners. Make sure they're all selected. Okay, so sometimes you have to hold shift and alt and click a couple of times to get this. We're going to bevel this outer edge as well. See? Okay, so we got the whole thing now. Control B, pull, not too much, just like that. And again, that will catch light on the edge because of the bevel, so you'll be able to see it better. Now the only thing I want to do, don't forget to save, is I want to look in, it's looking very narrow to me. I might want to extend all of this out just a little bit to get it a little bit to a square. It depends on the image that you look. It looks more square here. It looks pretty narrow here. So, you know, if we did want to do that, you look straight in orthographic view, go into edit mode, deselect everything, press Z and go into wireframe mode. Press 1, I like to do this in vertex selection, and box select. Press B and draw a rectangle around there. And just bring it out a little bit. Deselect, go back into solid view, and we've made it a little bit wider. Whether or not we needed that is another story. Okay. So, Inside is a panel like this. All right, so what we'll do is we'll, I think I'll use a separate piece. Let's go into edit mode and press 3 for face selection and select that face. And then bring the 3D cursor there. Shift S, cursor to selected. Go back into object mode. See, my 3D cursor is there. I'm going to bring in a new object. I'm going to bring in a plane, and it'll come in right there. So let's go to plane. There it is. I'm going to rotate X 90 and pull it out so I can see it in front. Let's scale this down until it looks like it's going to fit. It's like about there. Press 2 for edge selection. Pull that up near the top. Pull this one down near that part there. And we're going to bevel this. Now, this is just a single plane, so I'm going to select it all and press 1 for vertex selection. Look from the front, and I'm going to press Shift-Control-N-B. Shift-Control-N-B and pull. And I'm going to keep the 5 vertices. I'm just going to pull. It doesn't have to perfectly match the curvature of this. That's all right. So I've got that. I'm going to give this some thickness by pressing E, and I'm going to extrude backwards. But I'm going to scale it so that I get a bit of an angle like that. Then I'm going to press E again and come back straight. I want to get rid of this back face. We don't need it. X, F. Let's try that. Slide it into place. Push it down and see what we can see. Okay. Not bad. Let's bevel this top edge here. Go into edit mode. 3 for face selection and select that face. Control B and pull. I'll keep the 5 segments. And I think I'm going to scale this in the Y, make it a little bit thinner. SY and just pull. Do something like that. And let's try pulling that in. And there we have that. We have that piece in there. Maybe I'll SX. Maybe I'll scale it in the X a bit. Alright, so that piece is in there. I suppose we can do the smoothing now. Let's right click and shade smooth. Let's look at this, and we'll notice that it's all red. That means my polys are flipped the wrong way. So I'm going to select it, Alt-N, recalculate outside. Select the back piece, Alt-N, recalculate outside, and this one too. Okay, they're now facing the right way. For this piece, I right-clicked and pressed Shade Smooth. We're also going to need to add Weighted Normal, and under Normals, Auto Smooth, and just leave the 30. I think we're okay. Let me just try quickly Bevel, bring it up above there. I think we're going to need that, and then our shading issues are all solved. So it's a bevel just with the default settings. It's this weighted normals, and it's this auto smooth down there. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to shade smooth, and I am going to add bevel, collapse that, weighted normal, collapse that, and come down to auto smooth. And we have a nice looking model. Let's have a look so far at the statistics. All right, not too high. All right, it's going to go a little higher because I'm going to add subdivision surface to some knobs. So let's do those now. Shift A, mesh, circle. I'm going to choose 16 vertices. Go into edit mode and scale it. Rotate X 90. Push it out so we see it in front. Drag it over here and then look at the reference. Alright, it's over to the side. Let's look at another one. Okay, I'm looking for a big one here. So I'm going to scale that down. I'm going to pull it over to the side. And I'm going to go for something like that. It's not going to look exactly the same, but let's do that. And to make this knob, I'm going to press 1. I usually like to work in vertex selection so I see it. E and S, just come in a little ways like that. E, extrude out just a little ways, maybe taper it down by pressing S, E and S, come in, and F. So I've done that. Shift and Alt and click on that edge, E, and pull it back a bit. And that's going to be our knob, but now we'll bevel it. So I press 2 for edge selection, Shift Alt and click that edge and that edge. And let's Control B and pull. I really only need to roll my mouse back to 0 so I have the two edges and add one, because I'm going to add a subdivision surface on this. So go back into object mode and Control 1 for one subdivision. And it looks like that, but this area is a little undistinguished. So let's Control R to add a loop cut. Pull that down. I'm going to do one more there. All right, and that's going to be the knob that we're going to use. I'm going to slide that back so it makes contact like that. I'm going to use this to make the other knobs. So Shift D with it selected. Pull it down a little ways and S to scale. I want a smaller knob. I just want to make sure that it's in. Look from the front again. Shift D. Pull it down as well like that. And so now we have our three knobs there. We need to make this here. I mean, this is really a decal, of course, and this work is going to be, you know, texture work. In fact, I think, like I may have said, I'm not even sure that's geometry. And then we'll make those little pipe-like things going into the wall, and that's about it. So to do this piece here, what if we were to come in here and steal a piece from here? What if we selected this face? I went into three face selection, Shift-D, and just drag it down, pull it out, but separate it from this object, P, separate by selection. Go into object mode so we have this. Now I'm gonna wanna scale this, but be careful. Go into edit mode and wireframe, one, and box select these vertices, and then scale it like this. That'll keep the curvature of this. You can select the whole thing and move it down, and then just think about the size of this. Now this is a little bit more square than what I've got here. So, I mean, if you wanted to use a new plane, you could, but I'm going to keep it with the same curvature. I'm going to do it this way. Let's pull it down a little bit. I'm going to give it a little bit of thickness, E, gesture back, but I'm going to delete that back face. And then three, face selection. I'm going to bevel this. I'm going to put a couple of edges on there. We'll shade smooth, and we'll probably need to do the same thing we usually do. I'm going to add just a quick bevel. Quick weighted normal and auto smooth. No, I didn't hit that. There we go. Select the whole thing, pull it in until it makes contact. Look from the front, save, and have a look at the positioning of that. All right, that looks okay. Okay, it doesn't look exactly the same, but it looks like a very similar panel, I think. If you wanted to, just because we're doing this all in geometry, just for the fun of it, to model this in case, you know, you weren't going to do any more than modeling it and looking at it with a matte cap in the viewport display, what I would do is this. We could bring in our object there, or we could come in and say, you know what, we're going to do it right there. So let's Shift-S, cursor to select it. Bring the 3D cursor a little bit closer to where we want to work. Bring in a plane, a brand new plane. Rotate X90, scale it down, number one, just press G to grab, and move it in, say, I'm going to do it about there, let's see if that's about right, you know, yeah, it looks like it comes up almost to the top of this, and then near the bottom, so maybe we'll scale it a bit bigger, so it's like almost to the top of that, and that's good enough. Vertex selection, select these two vertices, and M, merge at center. All right, so now we have a triangle, select everything, so we have the vertices selected. Shift Control B to bevel, pull, but don't give it too much of a curve. But I generally will use 5. 3 I find is not enough, and no more. Okay, 5, gentle curve. 8 to select the whole thing. Let's just move it out. E, and let's pull it back in the Y just a little bit. X faces, and we're going to try beveling this. 3, grab this top face, Control B and pull, and we'll do the same trick, shade smooth, bevel, weighted normal, auto smooth, bring it in, And now you have a triangle made of geometry that with a nice curve that matches, I think, the theme of this. All right, time to do the pipes. Let's have a look here. We want our object to come in here, so we're going to select the bottom, Shift S, cursor to selected, close enough, Shift A, mesh. How about we use a cylinder this time? Let's not go for 32, how about 18? And we can leave n-gons. That's the top there. Scale it down. One, just press G to grab. I believe one is roughly in the middle there. In here. So we can start with that. Let's scale that in the Z a little bit and just pull it out so we can see what we got. We can delete in face selection, grab that face. We can delete that top one. But we'll use this bottom one. Let's grab that. Let's go Control B. And you can either hold down Shift or not. Just pull quite a bit to get it nice and round. Just don't go crossing it over like that. Something like that. And now I think I'll come back and in Edge Selection, Shift Alt and click there and just pull it in. We don't need quite that much. Select it all and pull it in. See what happens if we just shade smooth. It's not bad. I think it's a little bit big. So let's scale the whole thing and try to make sure that it fits in there. I think we can get away with something like that. Now, do we want this round or do we want to get rid of some of this? Do we want to take this and Control Plus? And do we want to SZ 0 to flatten it and pull it in? Make it more like that. Maybe even Control 1. Let's just go with that shape. All right, let's just make sure that it makes contact like that. And I'm just going to position it and scale it a little bit so I feel like it fits better. All right, we're going to create a pipe off of this. So let's use this and bring our 3D cursor right there. In fact, let's bring our 3D cursor right here. All right, Shift S, cursor selected, mesh plane. Now, what are we going to do with this? So from the side, I press 3 there. Go into edit mode and scale it down. I'm going to rotate this in the Y so it faces us. G and go like this. What I'm going to do here, going to number one, is I'm going to delete just this point. Watch this. And now I have this. So I took in a plane. Imagine there's a plane right there. This was facing us from the side, number three. Now I'm going to select just that point and I want that curved. Watch this. Shift Control B. Pull quite a bit. I want 5 points. So it looks like it's a pipe coming down here and here, but right now it's just that with like about 7 points in it. We're going to convert this to a curve. Convert to curve in the curve dialog box under geometry, under bevel. I'm going to hold down shift and the depth. I'm going to pull. I will shade smooth and control one for one subdivision. Look from the side, go into edit mode. You can see the points of the curve. And pull it. That I think probably looks okay, and I can't see it going into the wall, but I think what I would like to do is this. I think I would probably select those 2 points, Shift D and P to break it out. That gives me another segment of the pipe, but I'm going to make it a bit wider like this. All right, and then I'm going to choose fill caps just for this example. And I'll have that, and it looks like it kind of at least ends, it does something. All right, let's finish this off by taking this, I guess I'm moving a little bit higher up so it looks like it's inside more. All right, I'm gonna take this in edit mode and I'm just going to Shift D and I'm gonna copy it over to around the middle of this section. I think that's right. Yeah, maybe not quite the middle. That's probably okay though. All right, let's select both of them and Shift S, cursor selected. That'll bring the 3D cursor in between the middle of both of these. Now I can select this pipe, set the origin of it to the 3D cursor and choose mirror. I'm in the X and I'll mirror that right across. And same thing with this piece. Set the origin to the 3D cursor and then just choose mirror. And then I've got all of those. Well, the whole thing looks a little wimpy to me. So I think I'll come in here and I think I'm gonna bump up the thickness of these pipes to do that. And while I'm here, I'm just gonna bring them hot bigger. And maybe even bigger. I don't know, just so you can see them. Let's, by the way, double check our orientation. You can see some of these are flipped. So you can select everything and go into edit mode and Alt N, recalculate outside, and that'll do everything at once. How's our polys? Not too bad. It's not low poly, but. All right. At this point, I'm going to switch to a matte cap. And I'm going to try shadow. And just choose something that you think maybe would look cool. And there's our model. All right. If it was going against the wall, I probably would delete that. And it probably would go against the wall. So there it is. Is there anything that I've missed? I can't see the side very well, if there's any switches or anything. I'm not going to do the graphics on that. I think we've pretty much done it. All right, so I've got some other ones planned to do just like this, and I think we'll leave it there. Hopefully you followed along. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. And thank you for watching.